Hello.
Hello and welcome. This is News of the South. My name is Eugene Majuru, and I'm going to be speaking to Mr. Maxwell Chivasa, a journalist based in Slough. Mr. Chivasa has worked for the Herald, and he previously worked for Parade, the Zimbabwe Broadcasting Corporation, the Zimbabwe Mirror, and several other newspapers in Zimbabwe. So today we're going to be talking about the Zimbabwean cabinet reshuffle. Mr. Chivasa, can you tell me more about what you think about the recent cabinet reshuffle?
Oh, thank you for having me. I think the cabinet reshuffle was more centered on the change of position or loss of position of vice president for the former Minister of Justice, Mnangagwa.
Okay, a lot of people were thinking that President Robert Mugabe was going to remove the vice president, Mr. Emmerson Mnangagwa, but obviously this didn't happen. We saw changes in, for example, the Ministry of Finance, where Mr. Ignatius Chombo has now been appointed the new Minister of Finance and Economic Development. What do you think of this appointment?
I think of Mr. Ignatius Chombo, it was a surprise appointment. Many people didn't expect that, because sometimes people think that one has to have some experience in finance. But this time, Mr. Chumbo, or Dr. Chumbo, is a surprise appointment.
Yeah. Okay, and a lot of people have also been talking about the appointment of Mr. Chinamasa, who's now the Minister of Cyber Security, Threat Detection.
Yeah, that was a joke. People think that it has been found. It was a funny appointment as well. Some are saying, it's a WhatsApp minister, is now a WhatsApp group administrator. Yeah, it's a funny one. I think it's quite a big drop from Minister of Finance to become a Minister of whatever they call it, cyber, whatever.
Cybersecurity. Yes. Why do you think Mr. Chinamasa was demoted?
I think he mishandled the cash shortages. That was a disaster, because this is when we had lots of people selling cash on the street. You could phone from here in London and find out who is selling the US dollars where, and it was chaotic until just recently when President Mugabe intervened. Maybe that's when he said there were lots of people trying to cause problems for the government.
Okay, so,
He messed up the Minister of Finance, and even the governor, if he was a minister, if he was in political appointment, he was going to lose his post.
Okay, we also saw the Minister of former Minister of Tourism, Engineer Walter Mzembe, who has now been appointed Foreign Affairs Minister. What do you think we can expect from Mr. Mzembe? He did very well in tourism.
I think he should have remained at tourism. I don't know how someone can be promoted to become a Minister of Foreign Affairs, a totally different ministry, unless you know the foreign relations, international relations. It's much more serious ministry, because you'll be dealing with the foreign policies of other countries, which is totally different from marketing Zimbabwe. I don't know how that came about. Maybe they need more training. Maybe that's why we find that these ministers don't do well when they are given such posts, which they can't handle. Like Minister of Finance, Chinamasa couldn't handle the Minister of Finance. It was chaos. And look where he is now.
So, if you look at Mr. Mzembe's track record, you can actually see that he's managed to get Zimbabwe very much high on the international map.
On the map, yeah.
Yes,
yeah, yeah.
And he's achieved a lot. He achieved that the recent tourism event, was it the UNCTO? No, not the UNCTO.
I think tourism is not yet.
The one held at Victoria Falls. That was a great success.
Yeah, yeah, a big conference.
Yes, that saw a lot of people coming into Zimbabwe, and I'm sure they managed to make some money there as well. So looking at his previous track record, do you think that he can handle this foreign affairs, because he's known to be hardworking, serious in what he does, and his new role will mostly involve international relations, which he is capable of handling?
Yeah, I think foreign affairs is a bit of a serious ministry. It needs someone who can handle foreign affairs. Like right now, there's issues between South Africa and Zimbabwe, and there's issues between Zimbabwe and Britain and America. So we'll see. These are the three countries which he has to deal with and bring about smooth relations. Yeah, so that will be a test for him. If he can manage that, it's a totally different ballgame from running tourism and foreign affairs. How is he going to start? Maybe someone needs to ask him, what's his starting point? What are his plans? How is he going to improve relations between South Africa? You know, the recent events with
Albert Mpofu has been appointed the Minister of Home Affairs. In terms of Home Affairs, how do you think you will fare in this post?
Yeah, I think Urban Poff, I've known him for many years. He can handle that. I have no problem with that. I don't think anyone can hesitate how he's going to handle it. It's like Ignatius Chombo, he was able to handle the Minister of Home Affairs as well. Because I think those are easy ministries which you deal with the police commissioner, and they advise you what's going on, and it's law and order basically, so I don't think it's a problem.
Okay, we've also seen the CIO boss, Major General Bonyongwe, who's now been appointed the Minister of Justice, Legal and Parliamentary Affairs. How do you think this is going to work?
Yeah, I think as the Minister of Justice, he is the person who is dealing with has been dealing with the arrest of people and dealing with the security matters. So he should be, I think it was okay for him to be given that post. But it's the first time we've seen a security man from the CIO get a top post like this one.
Do you think that was a good move, or do you think it was a bad one? Why?
As Minister of Justice, it will be a test for him to see how he can handle issues from the police as well. It's a tricky one, because he's going to be handling issues that don't involve security. He was a security man, CIO, Central Intelligence issues. Now, as Minister of Justice, which was formerly held by Emmerson Mnangagwa, it's a difficult position for him to tackle. It's the first time we've seen a serving member of security being appointed to a cabinet post. I can't remember last time when we had that situation.
I've also noted that a lot of Zimbabweans were mostly interested in having the Minister of Education being reshuffled, Mr. Dokora. This didn't happen. Why do you think he remained?
Yeah, Dokora has been a very unpopular Minister of Education. still remember the issue of uniforms for teachers and his talk about introducing gold currency. Oh, that was laughable. We couldn't believe a minister of education can speak about in terms of gold being used as currency, although he tried to deny it, but it degraded him and he lost his esteem. We think that he should have gone. Maybe he should go in the next reshuffle.
Okay, a lot of people have criticized the new curriculum, and a lot of problems have been cited that it is unworkable. Why do you think the president decided to leave him in charge of the Ministry of Education with all that's going on, all the complaints? All the teaching staff have also complained that it is not workable, but surprisingly, he's remained in his post.
Yeah, it's a surprise, really, because he's the most unpopular minister I've ever had in Zimbabwe. They always talk about a cabinet reshuffle, him leaving the ministry, but he didn't leave. So now they have to put up with him. He should change the way he works around the schools and teachers and his policies. I think he brings something into the government because there are all sorts of allegations that he's in friends with those countries, Islamic countries, and he's sometimes you never know what he brings to the government or what he brings to the party. Maybe that's why he survived, how he survived. I don't know.
Okay. Also, Mr. Patrick Juao is now the Minister of Public Service, Labour and Social Welfare. He will now be in charge of all the civil servants.
Public service. Yeah.
Do you think this will bring a lot of improvement to the public services, to labor and social welfare?
Yeah, I think he's been under a bit of training in the Ministry of Youth. Now he's being elevated as president's relative, you know. He's bound to go up, there's no doubt about that. He's going to learn and improve the situation in the labor and social welfare area.
Okay, a lot of people have been talking about the Vice President, Emmerson Mnangagwa, and many people were actually thinking that the cabinet reshuffle was going to be done just to remove him. So obviously he's still there. What does that mean for Zimbabwe?
Yeah, it will be a disappointment for the president's wife, first lady, because everyone thought she was going to be happy if Nanga was removed. Most people suspected that she was going to be promoted to vice president and Mnanga were thrown out. That was the speculation from other journalists. But maybe because the president sees him as still a strong ZANU-PF personality, I think that's why he survived. Yeah, because if you look at the party as a whole, we think who is going to be the next strong person after president from the liberation struggle, it's only him. So he's a bit of a tricky cadre to just throw away from ZANU-PF.
Okay, there's not been a reshuffle in the Ministry of Health and Child Welfare. Do you think it might have been necessary to have a reshuffle in that ministry, considering that there are many problems in the health sector in Zimbabwe at the moment? A crisis, if I should say.
Yeah, the health sector in Zimbabwe leaves a lot to be desired, and people are going to get treatment in South Africa. The president goes to Singapore. It's unacceptable for people to be flying out. It's only those who can afford it. We've seen pictures of poor people being taken around to clinics for long distances in scotch carts, being pulled by donkeys, and some women in wheelbarrows, some on bikes. It's unacceptable, really. The health sector in Zimbabwe leaves a lot to be desired. I don't know what he's doing about it. It's embarrassing for top people to go to, or the elite for people to go to for treatment in South Africa, and the poor people have nothing to go to in Zimbabwe. Even if you go to a clinic, there's no medicine. There are no injections. They just get some tablets, that's it, or nothing. In the rural areas, it's worse. So that is a serious ministry which needs a lot of attention. Yes, work hard to improve the situation.
Do you think this recent cabinet reshuffle will see the alleviation of problems in Zimbabwe? Would you think the problems will remain the same, or they might get worse? What do you think?
Yeah, I think when people heard about the cabinet reshuffle, they thought it was going to be about removal of Vice President Mnangagwa because of his utterances here and there, changing the audiences. But the people who were worried about this cabinet shuffle were only his supporters or family members and his followers, and also his so-called Lacoste group. Why would Zimbabweans be worried about loss of or a cabinet minister or whoever? They won't lose sleep because it's a change position. People are worried about cash availability. They want money in their accounts. They want food. They don't want queues. They don't want to queue for fuel for hours. It's time wasted, time for development being wasted in queues. So, but if it was a change of Santiev government totally, yeah, then people would be excited looking at policies. But at the moment, the policies are still the same. There's no change in policies. It's still the Zimbabwe government. People are fed up.
With the appointment of Ignatius Chombo as the Minister of Finance and Economic Development, do you think we might see the return of the Zimbabwean dollar? This is what a lot of Zimbabweans are saying.
Yeah, that's speculation. I don't think people are prepared to travel with suitcases of the Zimbabwean dollar versus the US dollar. That one might even cost the government a few seats in parliament. Because
okay, in your own opinion, how do you think the cash shortage in Zimbabwe can be solved?
I think they should carry on with using the US dollar until there is sufficient evidence to introduce the Zimbabwean dollar. As it is, they can be fighting economic problems and fighting the currency problems. I know it's embarrassing for a country with no currency of its own. It's historic. It's never heard of. People don't. Most countries are proud of having their own currencies, but when you don't have one, better use the U.S. dollar. If you try to introduce your own currency at this time, there will be more chaos because we don't know how people who decide how the rating of this currency. It will be rated very poorly. So I think it's better to stick to the US dollar and try to find ways of making it more available and improve the economy. But the economy, you can't improve the economy without improving the politics. So first, I think the most important thing is the politics. The sanctions against Zimbabwe are because of the politics. The elections have to be free and fair. If the elections are not free and fair, no one is going to change their attitude towards Zimbabwe. It will still be Zimbabwe with underestimated currency. So you can't improve the currency without looking at the politics first.
Okay. Thank you so much, Mr. Maxwell Chivasa. She's a Zimbabwean journalist based in the United Kingdom in Slough. My name is Eugene Majuru from News of the South. You can follow us at www.newsofthesouth.com and you can subscribe to our YouTube channel to keep up with the videos that we post for you. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much.